infiltrated for quite some time now, and it is now showing itself. Obviously, there are some uncertainties. The presidency of Cyril Ramaphosa does not give us certainty of political stability, economic stability. It doesn't.
What fears does it give you?
The main fear for me, in particular, and liaising with people on the ground, ordinary people, is the fact that he is a symbol of white capital. His best friends are members of white monopoly capital. He himself has been turned into a capital accumulator, and therefore there is that fear that he is not going to implement the policies of the ANC. He hasn't been able to even pronounce radical economic transformation. It's so difficult for him to say it because he doesn't believe in it, because those who are behind him refuse to acknowledge it. In fact, they insult it. There's concern as to whether will he be able to implement free education, as Jacob Zuma has already pronounced it. So there are those fears. There is a fear that more white businesses are going to get more business from government and black businesses are not going to.
But you agree that we must give his presidency a chance before we can start casting aspersions?
I don't believe that we must give his presidency a chance. This man has showed himself that he's part of the white cabal that owns the economy of this country. So the ANC has failed us in electing a white man who is painted black. It's not a secret. He's part of them, and he has not denied it. He's been part of Bitvest. He's been part of Glencoe. He's been part of Coca-Cola. He has been showered with McDonald's. So he has been everywhere he has gone. He's been part of this white capital. So how do you look at what happened with Trump's? How do you then believe that this man will transform the lives of ordinary people?